YSR Grams, what's the word?
What's good,
Man, stuff with people not hip to what you got going on. Let's get them a little bit more familiar. Who is YSR Grams?
YSR Grams is an artist from Beecher, Michigan.
What's Beecher? What's the difference between Beecher and Flint?
Well, like, Beecher, like, it's like probably like 7-8 minutes for Flint, though. That's the crazy part, because Flint already small. Beecher, like, a little community, like, it's hard to explain this shit, because motherfuckers don't get it. Like, we got our own water and everything, though, so let me put that out there. That's what makes us different, you feel what I'm saying?
So y'all ain't got the same, like, contaminated Flint water?
Nah, we got our own water. But, like, one side of Beecher, like, if you live on this side of Beecher, like, it's a street cold water. This Beecher, this Flint. If you live, you got two zip codes, you feel what I'm saying? You might would have had the Flint water if you stayed on the other side. Close by Flint, you feel what I'm saying?
So how come everybody from Flint just not go to Beecher to get some water and then just walk back? It's like 7-8 minutes away.
It ain't like that though. You can't walk. Okay, like, you know what I'm saying? It's a little moves you gotta pull through to get through that bitch though. Okay. To sum everything up, it's just a community though, like outside of Flint, like it's an own neighborhood, like they the only blood, they got bloods and shit out there. They wear red out there, so that's what made it different. Cause everybody was TDs back in the day, like all dating family and all them. So that's the difference between all that shit for real.
So how is it growing up in Beecher? What is that like?
Oh, that shit funny as hell. And some shit, you're gonna get into a lot of fights. For real. You're gonna get into a lot of fights. There wasn't too much gun violence in Beecher. You feel what I'm saying? We stick together out there. All we gonna do is scrap and then shake hands. You're gonna get into a scrap out there though. Shit was kind of nice, though, and rough at the same time.
Well, how did you get into music?
Shit, really, though, I just always like rap, bro. I used to always watch music videos, listen to that nigga Pac, 50 Cent. Like, I listen to all genre of music. I just like that shit. I ended up going to the studio with my niggas one day, and shit, we walked to the north side. Speaking of walking and shit, we walked to the north side and shit, got in the studio. I rapped with my niggas and shit. I was in middle school. They said I was whack. So shit, I just kept going, and then my nigga Gabe died, so shit, that shit made me want to go way harder.
I could feel that for sure. So when was the point where you was like, all right, this is not just a song, like I'm just doing for fun no more, like this some shit I'm doing to take serious?
Shit, bro, let's say probably like 2 years ago, when I found out how to make a distro kid, for real. Once I figured that shit out and I seen like this shit more than rap for real. You feel what I'm saying? This shit different. You could probably feed your family, move your family out the hood off this shit. And I just took that shit serious.
So, what made you go with distro kid opposed to like TuneCore?
I wasn't really hip on TuneCore, you feel what I'm saying? I just got hip now. If I knew about TuneCore back when I had that, I would have switched. I feel like why I ain't switched is because like I feel like I had to start over. Feel what I'm saying? Like all your streams, you ain't gonna see that. If I start TuneCore today, I ain't gonna have as much streams that I had on DistroKid, you feel me? So I just choose that because that was the first.
I think DistroKid better in my opinion.
You think so?
Yeah.
I don't know. I gotta try TuneCore out to see what's popping with it.